Now I'd like to ask Stephen to come forward. Stephen, Lower Sackville, Knox United Church. He's part of the youth group there. He's also part of Youth Forum, and he's a self-described veteran of the United Church. And so here's Stephen to share with you his story of faith.
Alrighty. Hello, everybody. So I am here today to talk about my faith story, or a story of faith. I have a book that I wrote stuff in that I can consult, but I might not, living on the wild side. First I guess we'll talk about a wee little Stephen sitting in his pew next to his mummy, eating a mint that she gave to him about 10 minutes earlier because he was complaining. But then he's there singing, you know, a song. And he's tranquil, you know, he's calm, he's relaxed, you know. Because after a hard week of school, whether it be doing bad in class or being bullied because he's weird, you know, he could go to church and sing songs, you know, pray, all that good stuff, you know, just... That's what church always was to me. It was a sanctuary, beyond, you know, the obvious word for it. The church has always, it's been a very, very important thing in my life. It's molded me into the person I am right now. It goes a long way back to when I was in the Knox Kids for Christ. It's the kids choir, you know. That's when I first really started being a huge, not huge, like bigger part of my church. You know, that's when people started saying, "Hey, that kid's kind of cute." And then it changed a bit further on in my life when I started volunteering at turkey suppers or pancake suppers, you know. I'd be walking around all formal, he goes, you know, turkey supper, all that good stuff, you know. They were like, wow, that kid is kind of cool, you know. And then I joined my youth group, and youth group had one of the biggest effects on my life. I got to, I met Matt Wynot and Charlotte Wynot, and they've become now some of the biggest influences on my life. Just through youth group, I became a bigger, I don't even think of the word. I was seen more in the church, you know? And so more and more people were seeing, hey, Stephen, you know? And now recently, I play the drums in my church band, usually at the early services. But church is the one place where I feel like I can really pursue my faith in a very straightforward and non-judgmental way. And what my faith is that I believe that if I'm making another person happy, then I'm happy, you know? That's how I've always looked at it. Papers. Yeah. Besides being a church, you know, it's also been a bit of a personal hospital for my soul, you know. In the past few years, some pretty weird stuff has happened in my life, mainly at my house, you know. And there were days where I'd be at home in my room and I'd be thinking, why me, you know? It's thinking, you know, I can't deal with this, you know. But then at the end of the week, I'd go to church. I'd still be there with my mom, you know, holding her hand because it makes her feel good. And I'd be belting out songs in a deep voice like so. And everyone would be saying, oh, Stephen, I've known you since you were this tall. And I'd be like, who are you? No, but my faith has always been something that I've never had the easiest time saying it. Explaining it has always been a bit weird for me. So That's why through the church, I was able to show it in the one way I felt comfortable, and that was doing. Whether it be holding the door open for people or getting the kid that asked me a cup of juice after the service, or just anything. My faith has been a monumentally important part of my life, and without it, I would be a lot less confident. I wouldn't be as kind as I am, pretty sure. Yeah. Yeah. Thank you very much.